pretty awesome. So I spent the entire day listening, learning, taking in info from people that are crushing it in network marketing. And if that's your dream, that's your goal, that's your vision for what you want for your life, then this is definitely for you. The 6 top insights that I got while I was listening and learning today. So insight number 1 is recruiting without launching equals nothing. Recruiting without launching equals nothing. Now you might be saying, Summer, what does that mean? Well, first let me give you a little bit of background. This was shared by a gentleman who's been in network marketing for 20 plus years. His name is Coulter, and I think his best month so far in this endeavor has been over $80,000. So let me break it down for you what he is talking about here. Recruiting without launching equals, it equals nothing, my friend. It equals nothing. Because here's what happens. Sometimes we go out there and we hustle and we talk to people that we know and we share our product and we show the plan and we do all this stuff up front, and then they sign on the dotted line. We're like, yes, all right. But when we don't launch those people, it's like a revolving door. It's like one person on, the other person off, another person on, another person off. So the key to your success, and what's going to be the bridge, what's going to be the gateway, what's going to be the catalyst for you creating duplication in your business, is by launching your new people. I have done several different videos on launching, and we can do another one. We're not going to get into the details this time, but if that's something that you're like, yeah, okay, that makes sense. Obviously, someone, a lot of credibility talking about that, I will share with you, that is one of my personal pet peeves in network marketing, is when people don't launch their people, when they do like drive-by signings, right? They sign people up and they run. Well, that's a problem because the person doesn't know what they're doing. They spent all their money and now they have a bad taste in their mouth about what we do. So that is the first thing. The second thing was from a gentleman who has earned well over $600,000, best month, 60 grand plus. His name is Andy Dooley. And he talked about the 3 different modes of business. 3 different modes of business. Now, what might this be? Well, when you're building a business, there's different phases, okay? Sometimes we're in a great phase, and we'll talk about what that is, and sometimes not so great. So the perfect place that you want to be is in the building mode. What does building look like? That means you're personally doing the things that you want your team to do. You're out there, you're contacting new prospects. You are showing the plan. You are touching base with different people. You are doing the deed that gets it done, right? The income producing activities. And because you're doing it, then your team is actually just watching and kind of copycatting you. You know what I mean? Now, the second phase is the phase of management mode. And management mode is the death of many network marketers. What is management mode? Management mode is basically where you are managing people that are building. And this is not a good space to be, because even though in some companies your title is like managing consultant or, you know, managing director or whatever, we never want to get stuck where we're managing. We always want to be leading by example. We always want to be doing. So management mode is, again, you're helping orchestrate everything. And a lot of times people don't need orchestrating. They need a leader, not somebody that's telling them what to do, right? This isn't corporate America. So management mode, second place, don't want to be there. And the last part, which sometimes they have been people that have been in business 3 months, 6 months, a year, and they're not having the results that they're looking for, they end up in this category. And this is the category of blame mode, where we're like, start blaming the company, we start blaming our team, we start blaming different circumstances, people, or things in our life because we are not where we want to be. So those are the 3 different modes of building. And oftentimes, if you yourself personally, or maybe somebody in your team, is having a struggling moment, we can take a step back and look and say, hey, what phase of the business are we in? Are we in building? Are we in managing? Or are we in blame? And, oh, by the way, what can we do to snap out of that so that we can get into the building mode, which is where all the growth, all the activity, and all the goodness takes place? Are you with me? All right, so that was the second thing. The third thing, which is one of my personal philosophies, and so I love that this person shared this, but he talked about raising up leaders and passing the baton. You have got to raise up leaders. You know, there's a lot of people that do network marketing and they don't structure their business right, they don't structure their team right, so they kind of feel like they have an adult daycare center. And I will tell you, honest to goodness, that was me a number of years ago. We had built a business to about 5,000 people in the team. And I knew, at this point, I wanted to leave the state. I wanted to move across the country. I knew that if I left, I was going to be in trouble because this adult daycare center did not have leadership, aka my network marketing team. It did not have the proper leadership, right? And so you, as the leader of your team, want to focus on raising up leaders. How do we do that? Well, there's a couple of things that we look for. Some leaders are found, like they already have leadership skills, and some leaders are developed, okay? So whether you're finding or you are developing, you wanna dial in on those people. When they have the eye of the tiger and not the eye of the kitty, okay? When they're really ready to do something, then you wanna lock arms with those people. You wanna show them the ropes. You wanna help them learn and become experts in our profession. And in by doing that, you can literally pass the baton to them and they will do the business without you being there, which is ultimately the goal. It allows us to travel the beaches of the world, do what we want to do, live the life of our dreams. But if we do not do that, if we don't focus on raising up leaders and passing the baton, we end up with a daycare center. So you decide, pass the baton or daycare center, which would you like? Number four, this is awesome. And it applies to anything you are doing in life. Yes, this is about network marketing. That's what we're talking about. But we're also talking about the game of life. And so here's the takeaway. Here's the insight. Take responsibility for wherever you're at in your life. When you take responsibility for wherever you're at in your life, if you don't like something, whose fault was it? We can say it was our fault. But the flip side of that and the positive part of that is that if we don't like something, who is in charge of changing it? Who can be the one that makes all of the difference? You can. When you decide to take responsibility for where you're at in your life, in your business, in your finances, in your relationships, in your health, in your physical fitness, when you step up to the plate and you say, if it's going to be, it's up to me, then you have the power to change those things in your life. If it's outside external circumstances, then it's in somebody else's control and that kind of thing. So take control of your life, my friend. That is number four. Number five, okay? This was a tip that was coming from a gentleman who hit the very top level in his company in 5 months. Now that is basically, I don't want to say unheard of, but it's moving kind of fast, okay? So here's what he said, and I absolutely love it. He said, track your progress and be accountable to yourself. So here's what he did. When he was in his running phase, he would look at where he was at. Okay, it's day one. Where am I at? Who are my team runners that are in place? And what are my goals for the month? Fast forward, middle of the month, day 15. Hey, let's do a checkup from the neck up. Where are we at right now? What's going on? How are we looking for the month? And then on the last day of the month, obviously that is closeout. That's when we bust out the fireworks. That's when we get in the groove, right? And so closeout is essential. We want to have a strong closeout. And so what he did is he would track his progress. You know, it's funny because this is not a new concept, right? But so many people, we just don't do it. So what I would tell you is if you want to get to the top of your company, take on this philosophy. Take on the philosophy of someone who hit the top in 5 months, right? So find something that will work for you. Decide, hey, you know what? Maybe I'm going to have a journal that I keep a track of my progress. Maybe I'm going to have a spot on my computer, like an Excel spreadsheet. Maybe I'm going to have an app or open a note section on my phone. Decide what's going to work for you and then put it into practice in your life. Now, what's awesome about this is while this gentleman used it in his business, you can use this in any area of your life. So like right now, myself and my husband, we're on a fitness stretch, right? We have certain fitness goals that we're going for. So what do? We track. We look at, hey, where I'm at. Hey, what do I want to accomplish? Hey, how did I do before? Hey, what's the goal for the future, right? We kind of keep track of things. I know for myself, when I do workouts, I always look, okay, what weight did I lift last time? How many reps did I do last time? Can I beat my own personal best? And if you always focus on beating your own personal best, then obviously, you're going to get better one day at a time. All right, last one. This is from a gentleman. His name is Peter Nielsen. Peter is a very special man. He is amazing in the bodybuilding and fitness world, but he's also a very gentle, unique, and just incredible person. okay? And so let me give you a little bit of the track record so you kind of know. So Peter had some health complications, some things like internal bleeding. He had family issues going on at home, but he went on to overcome those things and took health and physical fitness in his life and made that the core foundation that he built everything else off of. He used that as something that would keep him strong, like a rock, versus something that would maybe hold him back. He ended up going on and winning 50 world championships and titles around bodybuilding. Okay, so here's what he has to say. I mean, obviously we know that is somebody with incredible discipline, right? But here's what he had to say. He said, don't give up on your dreams and goals. Now, I know that seems very simple, but he said this. When you get insecure about yourself, you miss the call that God has on your life. Mic drop, right? When you get insecure about yourself, you miss the call that God has on your life. So many times we get so wrapped up in what we're going to say, how we're going to look, what are people going to think, that we don't ever get out of our comfort zone and just go for it. Just decide, hey, you know what? Let me go say hi. Let me go talk to this person. Hey, let me go make it happen, right? We get so in our own head that when God gives us a moment in time, when God gives us an opportunity, when God gives us that person that you have been praying about, we don't step up to the plate. So do not miss the call that God has on your life. Get rid of the insecurities, maybe identify what they are and say, hey, you know what? Maybe in the past, this was a limiting belief that I had about my life. Maybe in the past, you know what? I felt afraid to talk to people, or I thought I was maybe an introvert, or, you know, I thought, you know, maybe I didn't have the right people skills, but that's something I'm getting better and better on every day. And I know that if my dream and my goal and the thing that God has put in my heart is to have a huge team, is to be financially free, is to help some people in the process, that I am going to change how I see myself. I'm going to let go of that baggage. I'm going to let go of that insecurity so that I can move forward into my future and into my destiny. So those were my six biggest insights from six-figure earners that I took away today. Now, if you, my friend, are at a spot in your life and first of all, if you did like this, if this added some value, let me know. But if you're at a spot in your life where you're like, okay, this makes sense. I'm getting it. I'm ready to go. And you are ready to go to the next level. You're ready for your breakthrough. You're ready to rank up. You're ready to earn that bonus car, start getting those bonus checks, and start having that extra freedom and option in your life. That's you. Then I got something for you. If you click on the link that's listed here in the description, you will gain access to a special bonus training. And this is the 10 steps for rank advancing. It will help you dial in on the core fundamentals of what you need to do to get to the top of your company. And just to kind of share with you, you know, why were we even talking about that, and how can we have these 10 steps? Well, in the past, myself and my husband have focused on raising up leaders. And now are so very humbled, gracious, and grateful that we have over 25 six-figure earners in our team. So we kind of have a little bit of a process. You want to know what that process is, then you can click on the link that's listed here in the description, enter your email, and it will take you to where you get access to this special bonus training. So guys, that is it for today. It was so great spending time with you. If this added some value to you, drop a comment below. Let me know. Feel free to tag. Feel free to share. And that is it. I will see you all next time.
For more great training and to receive your free bonus training, the 10-step process for getting out of your own way and finally rank advancing, visit summergeronimo.com.